Welcome students. Today I am doing chapter 5, continuity and derivative. The further questions, exercise 5.1 in the part 5. I hope students up to part 4 you properly understood and properly write it already in your notebook. So let's start our question number 17. Topic is same, continuity and discontinuity at a particular points. Here find out relation between A and B. Functions given at the position of 3. So students, here I will check the continuity, continuous or discontinuous. Because we are already given, it is a continuous. So you direct forward. What definitions? Yes, if F is continuous at x is equal to 3, you know that our basic definition of continuity, limit x tends to 3, negative function is equal to f3, and x tends to 3 positive functions. Yes, now 3 less than functions, you know ax plus 1. I just operate at the place of that fx ax plus 1. Same look here, f of 3, it is all equality. Again apply same function a of 3 plus 1 and just read about 2. 3 plus, yes, dx plus 3. And value put it. So here just a into 3 plus 1. Same as here b into 3 plus 3. Yes, students. Now I want the value for a and b in the relation types. So it is easy. This and that are same. So I just show out it is only one time. 3a plus 1 is equal to 3b plus 3. And you only just rearrange the terms. So I have 3a is equal to 3b plus 3 minus 1. So 3a is equal to 3b. And here too, divided by 3, a getting 3b by 3 plus 2 by 3. Finished. So what is the a? B plus 2 by 3. That is my relation between a and b. Here only and only students, I define here relations. That's easy something. Same students, I move ahead. Question number 18. For what value of lambda? This equal for lambda. Given function fx is continuous at x equal to 0. This up to first one. And after the second asking, what is the continuity at x equal to 1? That I explain by the second part. So first I going ahead to continuous at x equal to 0. So if given function fx is, yes, continuous at x is equal to 0. So you direct follow the definition, limit x tends to 0 less than exactly at 0 and limit x tends to 0 positive x. Students, just you focus on the questions where is a 0 less than, yes, it is first one. So lambda x square minus 2x, exact 0, again same 0 square minus 2 into 0, and last of them 0 positive, yes, positive function at 4x plus 1. Finally, done. Here lambda 0 minus 0, same 0 minus 0, and here 4 into 0 plus 1. Finally, here lambda into 0, indirectly students, it is 0. Huh? You know why I write this off? Because here lambda value is, finally remove that, and you are asking what is the value of lambda. So here this case is perpetually 0, here case is perpetually 0, for every lambda belongs to R. So 0 equal to 0 equal to 1, it is false statement. If you students hear true statement, then answer is different, and if you false statement, then answer is different. I go to false wise first. If you this false, then lambda belongs to R, is not exist, it is no value for lambda, here possible. Either you write down for every number of belongs to R, this function is not continuous. Both are true. Are going to continuous wise. So there is no value of lambda if fx is, yes, if fx is continuous function. Either you write down for every lambda belongs to R, f is not continuous, this answer is also true. Correct? And now I go to second case. What is the continuity at x equal to 1? So easy. I just check out at x equal to 1. First of all, if x less than 1, then x tends to 1 negative. Similarly, at x is equal to 1, fx. So first of all, I am going to 1 less than function. I hope you understand. Here x greater than 0. It means 1 coming, exact 1 coming, more than 1 coming, less than 1 coming. So fx is same. It is 4x plus 1. Here also 4x plus 1. And if x more than 1, then x tends to 1 positive. Yes. Now I apply our limit part. Limit x tends to 1 negative function. It is 4x plus 1. Students, you only apply x is equal to 1, huh? Never apply minus 1. So 4 of 1 plus 1 is 5. Same here as 1. My answer is 5. And last, limit x tends to 1 positive. Function same. It is 4x plus 1. So my answer is 4 into 1 plus 1. Finally, you getting 5. Now check. So that's why limit x tends to 1 negative function is equal to f1 and 1 positive function. These are the target of one. So fx is continuous at which place? Yes, at t x is equal to 1. And this is your answer. And these numerical students, here at a little time. Yes, now students, same is, I am going ahead, question number 19. Yes, students, this 19 is an IMP question. These are board level questions in asking an exam. Given gx is equal to x minus integer x, prove that it is discontinuity for every integer value. And these values are given. Greatest integer less than or equal to x. So before starting with some students, I just show out our all integers related diagrams. Here you consider one of the n, here n plus 1, here n plus 2, just like here n minus 1, just like n minus 2. Same as going here 3, 2, 1, 0. Any place you prove this numerical. I just choose that. Here this is n place, that one and one of the n one. Only these three criteria I explained. And focus actually on the only x is equal to n. So I start first at x is equal to n. We check down for every n belongs to integer. Yes, integer x. Your fx is the integer x. These are only experiments. Correct? So, students, if x less than n, then x tends to n negative functions. So, fx is going to your function f of n. Definitely it is integer of n. But this integer n is going to left hand side of n. Means this answer. So, here just I explain you. N minus 1 less than x less than n, only these two terms. Left hand side limit, you cover to left side value, it is a least function. And what is the least in between? N or n minus 1? Yes, this answer, I just apply a difference. And now start my sum. Limit x tends to n negative. Our question is gx. Yes, does this gx extend? So, limit. My gx is a x minus integer x. So, here n, here integer n. But I told already integer n is what? Yes, n minus 1 according to this condition. So, n minus n plus 1, my answer is only 1. And this case is happily done. I hope students you understand. Because I only explained it by this n level. You also explained by n plus 1 level. It's also true. Now I check n to less, after that n to plus. Now I this to explain. So one more time, same is here our fx cases is an integer x, but now I move ahead to if x more than n, then x tends to n positive. Yes, n positive. So fx is equal to your integer function x. Same explanation. Here f of n, same apply integer n. But answer is yes. Answer is the n to n plus 1 move ahead in the right side directions in integer. So in the integer value, if you put at x, your answer definitely only n. Because this box integer what? Greatest integer less than or equal to. So what is less than here? Only n. Now start limit x tends to n plus gx. Now actual question here start. X tends to n plus what is gx? X minus integer x, n minus integer n. Now what is integer x? N. So my answer is 0. Now you check. These two answers same. No. This answer is 1 and here 0. Finally, I did limit x tends to n less than gx is not equal to n positive gx. So, this gx discontinues at every n belongs to z. Therefore, gx is discontinuous at every integer, either x belongs to z. In that case, we are ending this. Yes, students. Now, students, same as I continue. Next one, question 20. Given function fx defined. Polynomial trigonometry and again polynomial constant function always continues. In that domain, we have given domain x is equal to pi. So I check in if x less than pi, then x tends to pi negative. So limit x tends to pi negative function. Same apply according to your definitions. Limit x tends to pi negative. My value is x square minus sin x plus y. So pi square sin pi. What is sin pi? Definitely 0. My value is pi square plus pi. Same is next one at x is equal to pi. Function same apply. X square minus sin x plus y. So f pi. I hope you understand. The same result pi square minus sin pi plus pi. So pi square minus 0 plus pi. My answer is pi square plus pi. These values are same. Now third case, if x more than pi, then x tends to pi positive. So limit same applications. Pi square minus, sorry, x square minus sin x plus pi. This value students just apply inside. So, here pi square, sin pi, and sin pi again I ask you, what is sin pi? Yes, sin pi is 0. So my answer is pi square plus pi. Finally, all are equal. So, limit x tends to pi negative function is equal to f pi, and x tends to pi positive function.
calculus.
At x is equal to pi, and these are the our polynomial, trigonometry, and again polynomial functions. Calculus already to know that. I just only here showing by our definition wise.
One more numerical, students,
related to our trigonometrics. Sine plus cos, sine minus cos, and sine into cos. Three numerical combined given.
Students, every trigonometric function is continuous function in that domain. Here I prove for sine and cos indivisibility. Continuity.
So suppose fx already given. Here I am just taking gx is a sin x and hx is a cos x, and both I prove in their domains 1 by 1 continuous. So, in domain the known x belongs to R. Here also x belongs to R. So, in the R range wise, the students prove by any number in the R. So, as I just prove is equal to 0.
As you like, you taking another number 0 place 30 degree, 40 degree, 45, 60, 90, any, either real constant also
I prove at 0. So, if x less than 0, x tends to 0 negative, proving the same pattern. It is the sine x function, sine 0, 0, same. At x is equal to 0, similarly apply fx is a sine x. What is that 0? Sine 0, again 0. The last case, if x more than 0, then x tends to 0 positive. So limit x tends to 0 positive sine x, sine 0.
Students, in proving, I again repeat you, different values are also correct.
And all are same. That's why limit 0 negative function, 0 at 0, and 0 positive function. Not here fx, you write down here gx. My mistake. Here gx. Therefore, gx is equal to sin x is continuous. At x is equal to 0. Similarly, it proves at x belongs to R. Students, you also write down after that similarly. Because one place already I check, another in direct. Similarly, I check this cos x. At same checking, x is equal to 0. Either this time I take pi. As you wish. So, if x less than pi, students, any number you are taking here? 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, pi, 180. So, then x tends to pi negative. So, limit x tends to pi negative cos x. What is cos pi? Yes, it is minus 1.
And cos pi will be minus 1. No, first case over. Add x is equal to pi. Our hx, cos x, so h pi is cos pi, but cos pi is how much?
Definitely minus 1.
Yes. Now if x more than pi, then x tends to pi positive. Function same apply. Limit x tends to pi positive, it is the cos x, cos pi, nothing new. All are same answer. So, finally I am done. Limit x tends to pi negative function for hx is equal to h of pi, similarly to g of 0 then. And here, limit x tends to pi positive of hx. Finally, over here, which is all reduced by equality to hx is equal to cos x is continuous. At 1, at x is equal to pi. Similarly, proving that x belongs to R. Now I start, students. After that, these are the exams.
So nothing. This 3 is 7 is also easy. Here I do. After this ending. So first one. What is the first one? Fx is equal to sin x plus cos x. Means gx plus hx is also continuous function. Why both are continuous? Because hx and gx already are 2 here. So in exam, if you first two things you necessarily write down this and that. Yes, students. Now second. Next, fx, sin x minus cos x, same result, gx minus hx is also continuous at the particular domain. And last, third one is also sin x into cos x. I just repeat here, gx into hx is also here, continuous function in their domain. So finally you are ready to prove it. Students, you must be prove this part and this. Then you can. Okay? Yes. Students, same as new question now I explained you 22. It is a total carbon copy of your 22. Question is there. Discuss the continuity cosine means cos x, cosecant means cosec x, secant means sec x, and cotangent means cot x is also prove here. I it is a continuous. But before starting this all, you must be prove cos x is continuity, sin x is continuity. Already I explained in previous one. So you first write down sin x full continuous. Then after write down all cos is continuous, is already cos I am moving here. Okay? So you both tables are already right first. After that I go to cosec x. Yes. So fx is our cosec x function. It is nothing, it is 1 by sin. I again repeat to students, this sin x already proved in the first part. But you first part here write down the I not mentioned here. And then sin x is never 0. When never 0? Every k pi. A belongs to z. Sin already function proved, it is continuous. That's why this function cosec x is also one continuous at x is equal to x not equal to k pi. Yes. This place are continuity. Next, similarly, our next function if I take it, it is a secant means secant. So same, 1 by cos, where cos not equal to 0, so every not equal to k plus 1. Why mean? This is not a continuous. So here also I just showing fx is a secant. He is also continuous at x not equal to k plus 1 by k. Well, k belongs to z. Last case, same as cotangent. Yes, it is cotangent is nothing, students. It is cot x. Cos by sine, where sine neighbor 0, in every neighbor k pi. So here also my answer is done. Yes, it is also what? Continuous at x not equal to k pi. K belongs to z. If you proving it then, just write down sin by cos. Cos not 0. Every not to k plus 1 by 2. And this sum easily done. But again I repeat this proving before. You must be prove cos is continuous. Must be proved sin is continuous. Then you are our happily done here. Both question of 21 and 22. Now continue students, question 23. Find all the points for discontinuity. Yes, For related discontinuity, we are asking the question. But students, I check first continuity and at the place of x equal to 0. So first I checking at x is equal to 0. If x less than 0, same application. X tends to 0 negative. Which function apply for less than 0? Yes. Sine is sin x. So limit. X tends to less than 0. Sin x by x. Definitely. This answer I hope you know. It is our limit property. Now x. X is equal to 0. What is the fx? Yes. R equal to 0 is this. X plus 1. So I have 0. 0 plus 1, my answer is only and only 1. And last case, if x more than 0, then x tends to 0 plus. But which function I utilize in this question? Yes, it is x plus 1. So finally, limit x tends to 0 positive, my function is putting that, my answer is 1. So you just are going to 1, 1, 1. So limit x tends to 0 negative function is equal to f0 and 0 positive function, all are the equal. That's why I taking given fx is continuous at x is equal to 0. My question is what? All points of discontinuity. This function are continuous at the x is equal to 0. It means I write down discontinuity is not possible for the cases of x is equal to 0. Either other than 0, discontinuity is possible. Yes, so last answer write down students. So every other than 0, fx is discontinuous. Function. But only x equal to 0 plus, it is a continuous. That's why students, I first checking out to our conditions level. Yes, now students, I going slowly, slowly ahead. Question number 24. Determine the given function I have defined is a continuous function. Condition given not equal to 0 and equal 0. First of all students, this indicate x less than 0 or x more than 0. Yes, less than 0, more than 0. Four condition given at a time one function. So first of all I start our sandwich rule wise. One of the proving sine range. Students, you ideally know sine range close bracket minus 1 to 1. Here I utilize sine function for 1 by x. Now x multiply 1 by x multiply and apply the limits at the place of x tends to 0 negative. Our question, this minus indicates students left hand side limit, and here same limit x tends to 0 positive. Right side limit. So both are combined explaining. It is a sandwich rule. Already you know students. Limit x tends to 0. X square into sine 1 by x. Now here 0 square. Here also 0 square. My answer is limit x tends to 0. So final done. X tends to 0. X square into sine 1 by x is 0. Students, here left hand side limit, right hand side limit, both I calculate, it is 0. And read again, at x is equal to 0, what is fx? 0. Yes, all answers are 0. So I just last showing after that, therefore limit x tends to 0 negative function is equal to f0 and limit x tends to 0 positive function. Finally, we did here, it is continuous function, but here I prove by our sandwich rule. Students, sometimes your power in the x step is given x raised to 3, x raised to 4, either n, any power given. But your answer is sure, it is continuous. So, at x is equal to 0, given f x is continuous function. It's very easy and simple process wise, students. I prove that this sum. Yes, students, similarly, I move ahead. Question number 25. Same question, examine the continuity related to your questions is not equal to 0 and equal 0. Again, I just divide you here less than 0 or more than 0, both conditions given at a time one function. So, same explanations. If x less than 0, then x tends to 0 negative. Function same, sine minus cos. And apply limits. X tends to 0 negative. My function. Students, it's very easy. Sin x minus cos x. Apply the value sin 0 minus cos 0. I hope you know sin 0, 0, cos 0, 1. My answer is minus. And at x is equal to 0, read the question, students. Your question already given. Add x is equal to 0. Exact minus 1. Is that 0? Minus 1. Check. Answer same? Yes. They are same. Now, last case. If x more than 0, then x tends to 0 positive. But function is first one. This one. Sin x minus cos x. So, I move ahead. Limit x tends to 0 positive. Our fx. Now, apply successfully fx value. So, limit x tends to 0 positive. It is sin x minus cos x. Put in the value sin 0 minus cos 0. What is sin 0? 0 cos 0. Yes, all answer same. So, limit x tends to 0 negative function is equal to f 0. And is equal to last 0 positive function. Students, finally done here. All answers are here equal values. So, given fx is continuous function at x is equal to 0. And here easily, students, up to question 25 in this exercise done here, right, students. Now, students, here I ending this part, and I hope you properly understood our continuity and discontinuity related numericals. Now, further explanations and further study, students, I explain you in the next video. Bye-bye.